there.
So we are witnessing now the knife round, guys, and it's going to be Mineski winning that one. So are they going to be looking to stay or switch?
We are going to find out closely here.
Looks like they're going to switch.
Mineski is going to stay at the... They are going to pick the CT side here, of course. Mirage is CT side of the map, so... We'll see what's going to happen here. This is the final game of the series. We'll find out who will be advancing in the bracket.
Bomb is actually right outside onto a site. And so it looks like Rekka's going to go for that standard, or, you know, that much more preferred for me, push into A from 3. They're going to be aggressively pushing through connector and then 2 from A main. And this is going to lead to Spencer right here onto Ninja, but he will get spotted out. X-Grade gets the headshot onto him. Retruck does have that defuse kit, but Adrian gets taken out from his hands, and Adrian was found out there, gets taken out as well. And Russo was the only casualty there for Rekka.
Alright, just so you guys know, this is not Adren. This is Adren.
Yeah, there's two Adrens, right? One from America, one from
EU.
Yeah, the one from Hellraisers.
Yeah, Hellraisers, Adren. Yeah. Smoke's coming in from Rekka.
Dubstep with the Deagle on top mid looking for the headshots.
But it's not going to matter though, because Rekka is going to go for an A-take here. Gi, the first person that's going to hear everybody rushing in. And the rushes are now coming in from Rekka. And the shots are now getting fired. Adren takes down Rousseau. Bentet and the rest of Rekka are cleaning up house. Almost a clean sweep here from Rekka. Suffering 2 casualties, but nonetheless, 2-0 coming in for Rekka.
So, one more round before Mineski can actually buy their first gun round here. So, what cheeky player are they going to go for? Another, maybe 4 stack onto the A site?
I think that is what's going to happen. They know that Mineski, well, it's actually a different story altogether. Mineski is stacking B. I think they think that... you know, they're going to, you know, switch things up, but that's not going to happen here. The take is now coming in. Oh, that Kobe coming in from Frost Misty. Spencer is in Palace. They don't know just...
Super Sis is looking right at Palace right now.
Yeah.
If he hears the bomb being planted down, but it's at the other side of the box, so... No, he can't. He actually can't stop the bomb being planted down.
The aim punch going against the Spencer there, but nonetheless, this is the first buy round here, the first gun round of the game. We'll see if Mineski would be able to turn things around at this point. It's a different story if you're battling against pistols. It's a totally different story if you're battling with rifles. And
flash into mid.
Take the mid, and the shots are getting fired. It's a bunch of free fires here at this point. And yeah, everything's pretty meta. Everybody's just playing it cool at this point. And Rousseau...
I think Rousseau spotted the head of the Spencer there.
Nah, he was actually in the smoke.
No, I could see a little bit of the head right there.
Oh, yeah.
But the Spencer already backing off. Right outside of the connector here. So he wants to play a little bit safe around his teammates. But this could just be a B flex for Rekka. Nice flash, but Retrack was able to react in time and get the kill onto Bentet there.
Yeah, it's quickly down to a 5v4 situation. The bomb is slowly getting carried to B at this point.
I guess from Gambit now? Okay, my bad.
Alright, so
I'm not Gambit. I haven't been updated in the
roster. You watch E-League last night?
No, man, I was working.
Oh.
I wasn't able to watch it. I was preparing for the stream today.
I was watching it together with Dota Pit at the same time because work. But yeah, it's a 4v4 situation. X-Grade gonna try and see if he get the pick, but Retract takes down Super Sis. X-Grade gonna try and see if he's gonna get the pick with his AWP. And he is pretty surrounded. The bomb is in Van right now. Is it in Van? Yeah, it is in Van. Frost missing is inside. The bomb has been dropped. Mineski finally gets around here.
If they can get the AWP, that's an easy upgrade for Mineski.
Yeah, Adrian with the AWP. He's been deadly with the AWP. Maybe he's not performing much with the AWP during the first map because, you know, nerves. This is his first time playing with Mineski, but...
You know, they gave it to Dubstep.
Oh, they gave it to Dubstep. Be sure. Be sure, my young man.
Yeah, Dubstep has been the one with Mineski playing on Southeast Asian tournaments for a long time, and he has been a good upper, a good stable upper for Mineski.
Yeah. And let's see what's going to happen here. The flash coming in from Dubstep. He's just playing it safer at this point, which is pretty smart. Basic, this basic CS coming in from both teams. Pretty standard setup. And Frost Misty and the rest of Rekka are just hanging out a bit, just waiting for an opening from Mineski. Waiting to penetrate Mineski.
Yeah. And I'm really liking how
Kappa.
Rekka here are playing on top mid, or on middle rather. They're using so much control of the map with all these smokes, all of these Molotovs.
Ooh, accurate. Takes down retract.
They can play around Mineski here, and Mineski have to defend these sites, get 2 to 3 kills or 1 to 2 kills with just the one defender. And that doesn't work for them. Rekka are in full swing because of that, you know, because of that mid control. No, Agent right at the top here, he gets spotted out, but he does win a duel against Super Sis. So as he drops down, Bendit spots him out, gets a kill. Dispenser finally touched down Frost Misty there, but the bomb has already been planted. Bendit gonna be charging in with a Season 75, and Dubstep will try to run away with this AWP here, as Rousseau is nowhere near him, so he might be able just to save this Zoom banger or maybe they'll hunt him down, I don't know.
Did you just call the AWP the Zoom Banger?
I forgot the other term that they call it.
Boomstick. Or, you know, just call it AWP.
Boomstick. Zoomer Banger. Because it zooms, and it's like a loud pop for it when you shoot it.
Dubstep gets pressing, he gets run! He gets two. That's
and the right. Zoomer Banger strikes again.
Press 1 if you want Azerite to stop saying Zoomer Banger. Just press 1, please. God, Azerite.
Heist!
But nonetheless, we are in the 6th round of the game. Rekka in the lead with four rounds in their pockets. And Dubstep playing the standard spot for an offer in Mirage, but the smokes are stopping him from getting the kill onto X-Crit.
And Rousseau is actually looking at sniper stats from underpass, hoping to maybe spot out Dubstep looking down upon him.
Mm-hmm.
And Spencer gets a headshot on the Frost Misty there.
And it's quickly down to a 5v4 situation. It's working well for Mineski, considering the fact that they have a couple of guys there running on pistols, not much on the economy standpoint there for Mineski. So any moment that they can get a kill, that's going to be pretty nice.
G was not spotted at all. Now he goes in with a little bit of a spray. Doesn't take down Super Sis, but he knows that he's coming up onto the paint room.
Mm-hmm.
The only one defending on the B side is an agent with only that 5-7.
And a 5-7 can be deadly. You gotta be fast on the trigger. And speaking of fast on the trigger, Adrian gets a double kill, gets a bomb drop. And the rest of Mineski are now rotating. And he's going to get a triple kill before getting taken down by Bentet. It's just on to Bentet's hand right now to save this. But no, Dispenser takes him down. Mineski is now catching up 2-4.
Still, actually that was enough that Rekka will have to go for either a Force Buy or an Eco.
And yeah, we're seeing a couple of buys here coming from Rekka. Yes, Tech-9s, P250s, and Deagles. I mean, this is just pretty smart. Oh, Dubstep!
Finding him as the smoke actually activates And now he's going to go for a second one. He's going a little bit wild with the Zoomer Banger here. He's going for that upper mid. He goes for the triple. Looks for the 4K. Looking for Benset there. But Benset does not actually want Dusted to get more, you know, that highlight reel. So he'll just let his teammate get that one. And Dubstep, wow, with that AWP.
You people are now typing one. Stop saying Zoomer Banger.
Hey, there was a two. There's a two right there.
I didn't say anything for two. We just want you to stop.
That's what it says four.
Oh, with the Zoomer Banger. Oh my God. Just call it AWP.
All right, fine. AWP.
Zoomer Banger is harder to pronounce. Oh, all that thought. Dispenser getting a kill onto Super Sis. Spots out three guys coming in, and the Paw Flash coming in from Dispenser.
Smokes onto Palace there just to stop anyone from maybe looking to be a little bit sneaky coming out from A main or anywhere near T spawn. But Rousseau gonna be charging in from lower mid, maybe onto connector here. Dispenser's very low in HP, and he's gonna be playing right around Sandwich, but he is easy target right now. But he does get the refrag right there, but he has shown his position. And Frost Misty, wait, what? He doesn't know.
Yeah, Frost Misty just jumps, and Dispenser misses his shot. Oh, he gets
Dispenser still missing his shots.
Oh wow, what's happening here? It's now down to a 1v1 situation. Benset versus Dubstep, AWP versus AK-47. Dubstep is gonna have to play it cool here. Benset doesn't know where Dubstep is.
But Benset is playing this calm and collected. He's just not gonna run at all, not gonna give any information. And if you check his point of view, he's looking at every single possible corner Dubstep might actually be at. I mean, Dubstep is on a one-shot, one kill, but at the same time, if he misses that, Benset already knows where Dubstep will be, and at the same time, he can actually play around Dubstep.
Yeah, and Dubstep is now going to go to rotate, go for the rotate to B. It's Benset planting the... Did he plant the bomb at...
Yeah, it's for...
For apartments?
Yeah, it's for apartments.
Okay. But yeah, Dubstep doesn't know where Benset is. This point, he knows that it's a bomb plant
for apartments,
and Bentet doesn't buy the fake.
The first defuse. He knows where Dubstep is. He's looking right at him.
And Dubstep being quick on the trigger.
He jumps right in the face of Bentet and gets that quick scope, or I think no scope, and wins. Clutches the round for Mineski.
Yeah, and Mineski is now catching up for. Four score line. Still anybody's ball game here at this point. But yeah, a couple of Tech Nines coming in from Rekka. Is this going to be a rush? I think this is going to be a rush.
So the first line of defense is definitely going to be G, or no? It's going to be G, right? Yeah. Here. But that smoke stopping Rekka's point or Rekka's force or. You know, they have four smokes. They can't go for that that cheese smoke, where it's just a straight line from A main to the A box. We'll see.
Yeah, we'll see what's going to happen here. And the rush is now coming in from Rekka.
I actually want to see it right now. Oh, goodness.
Yeah, and Dispenser and Dubstep taking down Rousseau and Frost Misty.
Oh, it kind of is.
Bomb has been... Ooh, that's a good smoke.
Yeah, the point of the smoke is just to actually get the bomb plant in.
Yeah.
And if they have, I guess, good enough coverage, they can actually get this win. XKid can just, you know, let this slide in.
He is going to stick the bomb plant.
He's really gonna go for the defuse here, for the contest there. He could have just saved the AWP and have fought for the next round. I think that would have been safer. Plus, they're gonna go into the next round with a lot of money.
I mean, I get the mindset there. If he takes down the defuser, that's gonna be more time for them to play around. It's better winning the round than losing the AWP.
Yeah.
I mean, they still have enough money to buy, but they're gonna suffer the next round if they lose the weapons.
Exactly. I think there was no real opportunity for him to actually clutch that. There was not enough time for him to position properly, and there was three people that he had to, you know, have exact positioning on, aim, shoot, and then try to go for the and then try to stop them from defusing at the same time. That's too many things for you to actually, you know, deal with. And now Dispenser, you're gonna get overwhelmed with Frost Misty. Nice anti-fragging coming in from the man. Now Dubstep with the AWP gets spotted out by Xerid, and they immediately eliminate three members from Inesky right now. And with that one, Adrian gonna be at least getting the refrag. Gonna get revenge for his fallen comrade, but at the same time, Rekka Esports with the full-blown control onto Bombsite A.
And yeah, down to a 4v2 situation. Inesky is gonna have to save their weapons here. They're not gonna be able to do much. And yeah, this round is gonna go to Rekka. Inesky, I think they're just gonna hope Rekka goes to them for the exits there.
Either that or they save their weapons, because yeah, they don't have a lot of cash to work with too. Maybe Retrack and G can buy up, but the other the remaining members of Inesky cannot.
Yeah, I mean, they'll be able to buy up at least an SMG or maybe a pistol for Dispenser there. Alright, boinka doink, I will call the AWP the Tokyo Sandblaster.
I don't know if that has a hidden meaning, but I'm going to stick with my Zoomer Banger.
Tokyo Sandblaster.
I am just going to stick with my Zoomer Banger.
The Tokyo Sandblaster.
Score is now tied to 5-5. And, well, right here, Inesky are able to drop with that double save. But again, if they lose this round, their economy is in tatters, dire straits, and that's going to give at least Rekka Esports possibly free 1-2 rounds. And again, if Inesky's not too overly aggressive with their ecos. Because you've seen how aggressive Rekka plays on their ecos with just the pistols, and they still win the rounds. We haven't seen Inesky do that too often.
Yeah, I mean, because the mindset, if you're coming in with in an eco, it's that you have nothing to lose. It's either you go hard or you go home.
Yeah, nice flash by Rousseau there, spotting out Dubstep as he was coming out of the murder hole.
And Dubstep not able to use a Tokyo Sandblaster!
And now Frost Misty spotting out Dispenser right at CT, but Xerid
with the kill with the Tokyo Sandblaster!
Oh my god, man.
Everzo cleaning things up. It's now 5-6. Rekka is now in the lead.
Oh man, I can't believe like you're really forcing it.
You're welcome, boinkadoink. But look at Xerid with the Tokyo Sandblaster! And 4 AKs for Rekka and
3 Inesky. Nades for Inesky here, and look at this, the Unison. They're gonna be popping in onto upper mid there and maybe nade stacking it, but at the same time you can see that Rekka Esports have no intention to play around with Inesky mind games, and they're just gonna rush in from B apps into the B side, and nobody from Inesky will spot this out. And Dispenser from Market almost gets taken down there, but hello, hello, here comes Adrian, gets the headshot onto super Frosty there.
And it's just Dispenser on his own with a USP.
Or Super Sis rather.
And he gets taken down by Frost Misty. And yeah, 5-7, Rekka is in the lead. What are you gonna ask for here? Rekka in the lead, almost securing the first half. Will this be another Deja Vu game? I mean, we are playing on Mirage, so Mirage, Deja Vu.
But to be fair, Inesky was stronger on Mirage when they still had Hannibal as their IGL, not their coach.
Yeah, Hannibal right now is the coach, so things are going to be different this time around.
Call the op. No, I'm not going to say that.
No, we're not going to say
That's
that.
That's too mean, man.
I mean, we would, but we can't. We don't want to. We don't want to.
No, we won't, dude. We won't.
We won't. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm already okay with the Zoomer Banger.
So you mean Tokyo Sandblaster?
It's the endless debate, guys. If you want
Tokyo Sandblaster,
go one. If you're gonna go for Zoomer Banger, press two. But now it's going to be a dedicated B rush here coming, or a B take here coming in from Rekka Esports, GI, as well as Adrian stopping him in their tracks with a 2K already, and Adrian going a little bit wild with Rousseau, taken down there, and Xerid does have the AWP, spots out Adrian, takes him down, but not going to be enough as GI was able to find the position correct enough to stop the man from B-Apps, and that's going to be another round won by Mineski.
And Guy actually takes the Tokyo Sandblaster! No, yeah, it was Guy, yeah.
So, closing in on to the last round of the first half, it's still neck to neck. Nobody has an insane amount, insane lead in terms of the rounds. Mineski are doing great controlling their CT side, and Rekka Esports even doing a greater job at playing around Mineski's weakness here in Mirage, which is mid control. But Mineski are gonna play a step further and actually go in aggressive and try to do something very ballsy here, and they get the catch onto Rousseau and even take some damage for a super assist and gets lots of information. Now Bispasser charging away from jungle onto jungle and gets spotted from the man in palace.
It's just Retrack and Adrian on their own.
The one time I kind of liked how Mineski were so aggressive on mid, that was the point where Rekka Esports were not emphasizing mid control.
Yeah, I mean, mid control is a huge factor in Mirage. As soon as you get mid, you have all the avenues to go to rotate or...
For the T side, but at the same time...
For the CT as well.
Yeah, in a way, I guess. Because I think it's much more important for T's is because you have the ramp already connecting from Catwalk and then connector. There's also the one for Paint Room. But at the same time, not the point. Rekka Esports, when they saw that mini, immediately they kind of pushed a little bit into the A site from the regular A main and palace, and those peaks actually spots out the one who peaked on underpass. Smart positioning there.
Smart positioning.
And smart peaking there as well.
But yeah, right now we are seeing the final round of this half. 6-8. Will it be a 7-8?
Look at that. Lots of 6-9. Number twos, man. Ah! No.
Man, let's just cast the game normally at this point. But Dispenser is gonna be the first one to go down. Bentet and Rousseau, they are cleaning up house. Adrian and Guy are going to have to rotate. Adrian is the only person here. He takes down one, takes down two. Gonna be a down to a 1v3 situation. Will Adrian be able to clutch this? That Molotov, he's gonna pass through the Molotov, and Adrian almost getting another kill, but it's not going to be enough. Rekka closes out the first half with 9-6 on the scoreboard.
So now we're going to go into the second half with Rekka Esports. Only one more win to at least getting that two-digit round.
Yeah, two-digit round now. We'll see. This may be a deja vu, you know, because Mineski might be able to catch up. They are now the T side. They are dictating the momentum here. They're dictating the tempo.
Yeah, but they have to still be careful because we've seen Rekka do a lot of damage with those USPs, especially on Cobblestone, and they could actually replicate that coming in on this Mirage map. So looking right at Palace right here, and the one other on CT is going to be Super Assist, and there you go. The first headshot, the second headshot. It's working out well for them for that 1-for-2 trade. And here comes Rousseau. Sneaky Beaky playing at the edge of that smoke. He spots the head of Dispenser there. Here's the drop from Dubstep. And he has to back away a little bit as his teammates are going to be coming in for the support or for the retake itself. Xcrit spots out the one. Look at these headshots that's coming in from Rekka Esports. But at the same time, Mineski's not going to allow any shenanigans. They get some kills of their own, and Bentet is in a 2v1. Can he get it? He's trying to reload right now, but no, there's too much firepower coming in from that Tech9, and that's going to be it. Mineski win this first gun round of the second half.
Pistol round of the second half.
Oh, sorry, pistol round. Thank you.
There you go. And yeah, Mineski, I mean, this almost guarantees them three straight rounds, especially considering the fact that they did win the pistol round. They'll be first three rounds automatic. That's going to be theirs unless they mess up and Rekka finds an opening. There we go. And yeah, Rekka Esports with four CZs. They are playing a bit aggressive here in their positioning, especially at A, considering the fact that, you know, they are at Palace, aggressively guarding Palace, I mean. But yeah, this is going to be a B take from Mineski. Retract is in Palace, going to be playing the lurk position. And Rekka Esports is now getting information that, A, they're not here at A, they might be at Palace, but they don't know that just yet. And the bomb is slowly rotating away from B. I'm guessing this is going to be a split B take.
Mineski are trying to read this as much as possible, but they're not spawning anyone out, so they're just playing this safely. I think they just want to go for the A side, which has more space to work with, which the weapons actually have more impact. But G, as he was trying to peek and, you know, clear out some angles, Supersys finds him, and Dispenser gets the kill right there. He's looking for more. He gets two already, and here comes Bentet peeking in, gets the kill onto Dispenser. Great kill for him, but now only Rizzo remains.
And Rizzo with that CZ, 12 ammo, 12 bullets, not gonna be enough. He actually takes the kill onto Adrian, gets another CZ, swapping out the CZ for another CZ.
When in doubt, use that CZ, I guess.
That burst potential of the CZ is not to be joked around.
Yeah, intense fire rate is very strong as well.
Exactly. And it's now 8-9. Mineski is catching up. What is up, Delminions Gaming? What's up? But, yeah, what?
So let's check out the scoreline first. Bentet with 19 kills. So he's been leading in terms of that kill ratio. Or that kill percentage. And now they're just going to go super aggressive here. And Supersys as well as Rousseau are not going to be able to survive. Bentet coming in from CT. Does put a good amount of damage onto Dispenser, but not going to be enough. They're going to chase him down at least to maybe get one weapon off the hands of Mineski. And they do.
And that shot from Bentet, taking that Dispenser, dubstep with the retract there. Boss Missy gonna try to see if he can get the kill, but no, retract takes it out. It's now tied 9-9. Mineski ties up the game. And this is starting to be a nail biter for them.
Nail biter indeed.
And yeah, and both of these
ever since this second half started, Mineski have taken three straight rounds. Rekka have gotten none yet. Now this continues. Rekka might actually be in heaps of trouble here, but X-Great does have the AWP, but he gets flushed out with that the Molotov on the connector area. And now Mineski have good control of the upper mid area. They're looking to actually do what Rekka Esports did to them, and they still haven't lost anyone yet. They're trying to go for a safe cross wall, not smoking out connector, so that might be a little bit dangerous, but the Molotov will provide at least some ample support as Dispenser is looking right outside of vents here.
Ladder room.
Or ladder room, well, yeah. But ladder room window.
There you go. It's 5v4. Rekka is... Rekka almost saw...
Rousseau did spawn it out.
Rousseau almost saw retract there. And they know this, someone's coming in from jungle. They know there's going to be an A-take. Dispenser takes down Rizzo and gets a refrag there. And it's now down to a 3v3 situation. The bomb hasn't been planted yet. And Dubstep takes down Supersys. 2v2. 2v1. Dubstep all on his own. It's just him versus the world. And the bomb is now in the hands of Rekka. That Nate almost gets him. But Frost Misty is the one that gets him. Wow. 9-10, Rekka is now in the lead.
So we'll see here as with Rekka Esports actually getting a good defense there. They have stopped at least the momentum that Mineski were building as they did start off the second round, and X-Gate finding a Dispenser right there. Looks like G gonna be pushing from B apps. Bente will be defending and jumping up and down, looking for that scouting potential. Spots out G there, so he's just gonna back away as he has Very minimal support. Well, Frost Mist is there, but still. They don't have too much utilities to work with, and they don't want to... It looks like they don't want to expend their smokes just yet.
Yeah, the proper use of utilities at this point it would be a game changer for both of these teams, actually. Because if you use your smokes wisely, like that one at the connector, they're delaying the push from Mineski and denying information from both teams, actually. That's what I've been stressing out. You need to make better use of your utilities, and Frost Missy is going to try to see if he can get a double kill, but that is not going to happen. It's now down to a 3v4 situation. And Adrian takes down Supersys, and wow, it's just Gee on his own, so 1v2 situation. This is still pretty doable for Gee. He has the bomb, he can still dictate the momentum, but he doesn't know where the rest of Rekka is. He's slowly going to push for A. Everybody is walking, everybody's silent at this point.
Yeah, he's just trying to run the clock down a little bit here. He's hoping that Rekka is actually still near bombsite B, but they kind of sniff out where G is. He's not doubling back to bombsite B to actually maybe go for the double fake, so this plant will be immediately spotted out by X-Crit, and if he spots this...
And he misses a shot, and it's now down to a 1v1 situation, and Rousseau takes down G.
Wasn't enough, though.
Yeah, it's not going to be enough. Rekka is now in the lead here. 11-9.
So Rekka getting another round. Well, to be fair, X-Crit was just more of a bait, and then if he could get at least the flick, that would have, you know, stapled that round for them. But he did have his teammate, Supersys, to help him out.
Yeah, and look at Mineski, they are not working well here with the pistols. A couple of P250s, a Deagle, and the Tech-9. They have to go all out here on A. At least force the plant, you know. As soon as they get the plant, they'll be able to buy decently in the next round.
They do have the flashes to maybe make that work, and set up smoke here. But at the same time, Rekka Esports, they have so much utility to work with that. With that accompanied Adrian. With, you know, their superior fire weapons, firepower. They will be able to overwhelm Mineski here, but it looks like Mineski are going to say otherwise with the retrack, as well as Dubstep still surviving, and Dubstep even able to steal an AWP. And will he just try to save that, or will he go for the fight?
No, he's just going to force a 1v2. Yeah, he's going to fight, but he doesn't know that somebody's right behind him. He doesn't know that Benta is right behind him, oh my god. But he actually misses a shot. Dubstep is fighting on all fronts, and it's not going to be enough. Rekka is going to get this 9-12. Will Mineski be able to turn things around? Type 1 if you think Rekka's going to win this. Type 2 if you think Mineski is going to win this. This is going to be an elimination. So it's, you know, it's time to... The steel of the nerves.
Yeah, both teams have worked so hard, you know, for fighting for this one. At the same time, it might not actually work for Mineski's favor here, because right now, I mean, they did get a good bomb plant, but at the same time, they kind of forced too many bodies on that one. They lost a lot of teammates, and I don't know, it's not working too well in my opinion. And now they've lost two members as well. This 20-second round is not looking good at all.
Yeah, I mean, if there's time for you to... If you're gonna have to go for a pause, now is a good time to go for a pause.
Tactical pause to talk. To at least, you know, retain your composure, see what happens.
See what happens, and we're gonna find out what's gonna happen here, and Rekka is going to take the game. The 13-9. Mineski, if you're gonna go for a tactical pause, go for it right now.
Three more rounds for Rekka Esports, and they win this one. Looks like they're showing that they are not just any team to be trifled with. They are the representatives for the Southeast Asian team. For the Southeast Asian qualifiers, rather, from last year. Mineski, another refresh on their roster, or a change in their roster. and it looks to be promising, but can still be sharpened into something more.
Yeah, I mean, this is the first time I've seen them play together with the new roster, so we're gonna see if Adrian's gonna adjust, because he's the one that needs to adjust to Mineski at this point. Excuse me.
This looks like it's gonna be an A push. Xcrit already has the angle on to Palace. So a fast drop into the site would be very useful, but Dispenser kind of slow peeks him and gets punished right off the bat. GI to follow, and he might actually just give it. He actually gets tagged right there, and the rest of Rekka Esports are just mowing them down. It's going to be Mineski losing this one yet again. Two more rounds, and Rekka Esports are close to getting the W.
And yeah, if it's at any point and they need to go for a timeout, now is the time. They need to, you know, they need to let go of whatever they're feeling right now. I'm pretty sure they're feeling the pressure, so they just need to catch their breaths, relax, and they're not gonna do it. They're just going to force it. They're just gonna play this out.
Well, Xcrit, look at this. He's gonna be forcing himself onto underpass, gonna make his little hidey hole, and he does find Dubstep there. Dubstep didn't expect him to actually be in that angle, and Rekka Esports pulling out all the cheese here. And right now, as this game is about to end, and Mineski don't know what's happening.
Yeah, it's a 4v4 situation. I mean, Mineski thrives in this environment. They like to feel the pressure. But I don't know if this is going to be a positive impact for them. Oh, that shot from Frost Misty.
And he was so low in HP too. GI is, or G rather, is going to be feeling that. I guess a little bit frustrated on that one. And Xcrit, he's done it once already. As this round started, he's gonna do it yet again. Mineski down to two remaining members, and Rekka Esports are rotating this map, this entire map, like it's their own home turf, and they are.
And yeah, it's a 2v4 situation. Mineski is not gonna be able to do much here, but Adrian actually takes down Frost Misty, brings it out to the 2v3. They just need to play it smart. They still have 30 seconds, but They need to rotate the bomb now. Retrack is hauling his way all over to B. 25 seconds left. That is not going to be enough. And Rizzo is going to be the first one to spot Mineski from rushing. We're going to spot Mineski. And there you go. The Flash is going to give it away.
They're going to drop down onto the site. And Rizzo is here. He's gonna be spraying, and he knows where Retrack is. He even stops the bomb plant. Yes, Adrian gets the kill, but that's not gonna be enough. They still lose the round, and even if he saves that AWP, he has to make it work. This is the last round before Rekka Esports take it all and put Mineski out in the streets in this tournament.
It's now Rekka Esports match point. Will Mineski find their answer?
That's the question. That single AWP save that you could say that Adrian did, it's a little bit of a silver lining here for them. Maybe maybe they're redeeming weapon, but at the same time, if he can't make it happen for six straight rounds, it's over, playa.
It's over, playa, in the 4v4. This is still anybody's ball game, but Mineski, they are feeling the pressure right at this point. I don't know how Mineski could come back from this, to be honest. Mineski, he has a couple of flashes, smoke, and a molly, but they need to make use of it because Rekka Esports, they are just on fire.
The problem is
the flame of Rekka.
They don't know where Rekka Esports positioned themselves. They're so fast. They're so quick to read how Mineski are actually moving from very little amounts of information that Mineski has to make something big and has to make that big thing fast.
And there you go. Frostbeast takes down Geese. Now down to Adrian and Dubstep. 2v4 situation. It's just down to Dubstep. Will he be able to clutch this? Dubstep going insane, but it's not going to be enough.
The people from Connector were so fast onto responding that Dubstep, even if he got those two good kills, numbers advantage were still in favor of Rekka Esports, and that's gonna be it, ladies and gentlemen.
And Rekka Esports just wrecking Mineski there on Mirage. Mineski, they did well. Congratulations to Rekka for...